Hey everyone, it's Dr. Edmund. Today we're going to talk about the Salesforce Associate Exam with emphasis on navigation. This portion of the test is 28%. It's all about scenarios on how to move around and find things within Salesforce. So we're going to talk about how we can move from tab to tab. We're also going to talk about the setup menu. Within Salesforce, there are a couple standard objects that every Salesforce org has, and then there's custom objects that we can add on after the fact. But the standard objects are your accounts, contacts, opportunities, lead cases, activities, that's your task and events, products, campaigns, campaign members, users, and assets. Every now and then, you'll have to get some pre-built solutions, and we go to the App Exchange to find those things. So on the App Exchange, we have pre-built solutions that are available to us that we can either get for free or pay for. We install them to our org, and we do really cool things with them. This here is the App Exchange. We have our top categories right now, but you can basically search anything here. My favorite thing is to check out the Salesforce Labs. So I just type in Labs in here. I can check out all the cool Salesforce Labs applications that are out there. They have everything from SurveyForce to adoption dashboards. So there's a pre-built solution. So there's pre-built parts that you can install into your org. And then you can take these apps, put them in your org. Like I said, some are free, some you pay for. If you have that thing that's commonly used across the board for things, come to the App Exchange and check things out. You're going to find some really cool stuff in there. With Salesforce search settings, you can customize the search layouts. This is basically how you see the results that return back to you. You can customize search results. You can create synonym groups. You can disable objects from search. When you do this, it makes your search faster. You can load data in off hours. I always recommend loading data in off hours. That way it can be indexed. Once it's indexed, then you can search it. Limit the number of fields to search. This makes your search faster because it doesn't have as many fields to search through. And just a reminder, not all fields are searchable. Things like formula fields aren't a searchable field. So if you want to search for something, make sure it's one of those data types that is searchable. In Salesforce, we can search by going to the global search here, click on that search menu there, and then you can type in where you want to search. I can type in the word boxer, and it will return back results. And I can see that I have returned back a lead, and it shows that no other records match that criteria as well. So I just have the one lead that matches that. So that's how you set up our search. That's how you search within Salesforce. How you can kind of move around here. If we move over to little gear here and click on the setup, this takes up setup page here. From here, we can just go from a home object manager, but we can also search in here as well. So I can search for myself and I can make a return here and I see my user record there. So I can search for things within setup as well. Setup only searches within setup. The other tab there only searches the record. So two different areas of search, two different things that you can do within there. In addition to that setup page there, there's also the company settings. From there, we can check out our company information. This is information about your company. You can check out your fiscal year, your licenses, your business hours and holidays, where you can manage currencies and trusted IP ranges as well. To get to company setup from your setup page here, once again, that's at the little gear there. Click setup. Takes us back to our setup page here. From the home tab, type in company. We can click on company information, and then from there we can see our information. So we can see that we have organization name, our primary contact, our default languages, local currency, data that's used in the org, our licenses, permission sets, all that fun stuff. Over here we can also see our fiscal year, so we can check out what our fiscal year, how we set that up as. It's a standard one. We can check out our holidays. If there's any holidays that we've created, we can check them out there. And then we can also check out my domain and your language settings as well. List views. List views can be seen as every tab in Salesforce. From the list view, we can check out the records that match the criteria for the list view. I always call list views as a little mini report, and there's a lot of cool things we can do with a list view. Back on our sales app here, we can see that we're in our sales app. These are apps, their home pages, and all this fun stuff. If we go over to a lead record here, we can see that we have our most recent leads seen to us. Here we can click our drop down and we can see all the other list views that are available to us. We can customize them. We can say, let's look at all open leads. We can customize the fields that are seen here. We can also customize the records that show. The easiest way to check that out is to go ahead and create a new list view. And we can set this one up as the new. And we can specify who can see this list view by specifying only I can see this. This view, all users can see this, or just share with a group of users. In this org, like I said, it's a playground, not going to be much of a big deal to you since I'm the only one who has access to here, but this could impact who sees this list view depending on who you give access to. When I hit save, It's going to ask me how I want to filter it. Depending on how you have things set up, you might just filter them by all leads, my leads, whatever up to you. Then you click done. Then you add additional filters. I'm going to add one of, I'm going to go add one of state here. And I'm going to say where the value equals Florida. Click done. Click save. And then it's going to filter that for me. It's got the ones that are shown there. Maybe I want to remove some of these fields, columns there. I can come back here and click the edit and select fields to display. And I can remove something like unread by owner. Maybe I don't want that in there. And I can go ahead and click save. And that removes that field from that search. In addition to the search that we have there, we can also go ahead and go back to our all open leads. And we can review how we want to see that data. We can click our pie chart there. We can select different charts if we want. We can change our update the settings here how we want. We can do a vertical bar chart. We can see what's where by what source. We can also change our display. So we can do table, which we see right now. We can do a combine. And we can see that, how that's set up like that. It's based on the status of the lead. And then we can also open up a split view, which allows us to see all our open leads. If I click on this one here, it shows me the record of the lead, but it still has that list view on the side there. You can always change it back to the table if I want as well. All right, that's the list views in a nutshell. With user setup, we can create and edit users. We can reset passwords. We can grant permissions. We can create and manage users. Just as a little note, you can create up to 10 users at a time using a little fancy tool in there. This is where we can unlock users. If users lock themselves out, we have to let them back in. Also where we can deactivate a user. You can deactivate a user. You don't delete them. Just that means that user's no longer to log in. It can freeze or unfreeze users. Freezing prevents a user from being able to log in, but actively consumes a Salesforce license. To view users, we go back to our setup menu underneath the home there. We can either click users here, or we can go underneath administration, clicking users, and check out our users. We have existing users here. To set a new user up, we click the new user. From here, we would give it a name, email, username, nickname, any other information we want to fill out. On this side here, we would fill out the type of license they would have, the type of profile. You can choose the type of profile depending on what their needs are. You can assign a role if need be, and then you can give them additional privileges at this point. Within Salesforce, occasionally you have the need to create custom objects. Custom objects are a way where you can design a object or a table to support your processes. It's a way to gather additional information. An example of a custom object I have is a certification object where I track the number of certifications you have or that you're looking for. These are objects that aren't included with Salesforce, so you have to build them. You have to build them from scratch and add all the fields to them. And we'll get into that in a minute here. All right, from Salesforce again, we want to click on that little gear, go back to setup here. And for the objects, to create new objects or new fields, we also have to go to the object manager. From here, we can check out the schema builder. This is where we can see all the different objects and how they're associated with each other. And I can quickly load this page here. We can see we have all the values here. But if I wanted to see select ones, I can remove them here. And let's say I just want to clear all. We'll do account and case. So over here, you can see they're here. So we can grab our account. We'll drag it closer to the case object. So this is just a way to visualize the different objects. So we have account object, case object, and how they're associated to each other within Salesforce. So this is a really cool way to do that. In order to create leads, we want to go back to our object manager and click this little create button. And there's two ways we can do it. We can build a custom object and also build a custom object from our spreadsheet. So if we had an Excel sheet that has a bunch of the column headers in there, this can actually import and create the records. I have a video on that, so go ahead and check that one out. But we can create a custom object. We give it a name, test object. And the way it went to the test object, we can give it a record name or type. We can say we want to allow it for reports or activities. And then we can say it's deployed or not deployed. We can say we want to allow search. Remember, back to that search settings. If we don't want this object to be searched, we don't include it for search. If we do want to be searched, we allow for search. If we add default notes and attachments, we can do that there as well. If you want to create a tab for this, I strongly recommend launching that. Click save. And test objects is my plural value. Now I hit save. All right, from there, we can select our object type. We can select our style. They come with a bunch of pre-built ones that you can select. I'm going to go ahead and grab the books icon. and click next. And now I will say I'm going to apply the tab visibility. Next, I'm going to say we're sure included in all the tabs that are for all the apps, and then we're good to go. Now we have a custom object. If I look in here, I can look for test objects, and I have a test object with just a name on there. If I want to add additional fields, we're going to go back to setup here. And from setup, we go back to object manager. We can check out our test object by searching here. Get test object, fields and relationships. So these are the ones that come out with it by default. We can click new, and I can say I want a new checkbox. Give that there and say test object field. Next, sign out the permissions, add it to page out, save. And now if I go to my test object here, click create, new, I can see that I have my name and a test object field, and I can say test object. You can check the field, and that's a custom object. One of the last things we're going to talk about is the Lightning App Builder. Once again, in the setup menu, this is where we can build app pages, home pages, and record pages. This is where we build all our Lightning stuff. We'll get into that in a second here. Once again, from the setup menu, we click setup, go there. Once we're here in our side menu here, we can type in app. You can go to the app manager if you want to check out the app manager. This, if you want to clone apps, you can turn that on. That's in beta, but this is where we can come and check all the different apps that are available to us. I'm going to click see one of the existing ones. I can click edit. Let's go to one that is actually in Lightning. Click edit. From there, you can see the app details, the options for it, if you want to, how you want to support it, the utilities, if you have any of those set up there, that's like a call or a chat message, navigation apps. These are the different items you want to be added to this. If I want to say I can't want an account on that, I can hit save. You see our test object, which we added the previous stuff there, is there already. And if we want to assign it to profiles, we can also select which profiles we want that to be assigned to. All right. One of the easiest ways to ever find a Lightning page for an object is to go to that object. We click on account here. We can check out the account page layout. Lightning record pages. So there's page layouts. This is the details of the page layout. Lightning record pages is the actual layout. There's none here. If you ever want to see what the default looks like, you can go to any record and I go to the accounts tab here. Click on Burlington Textiles. And this is the default Lightning app page. If I click edit here, I can edit page. This will take me to the Lightning app builder for this particular page. From here, I can customize the layout of how I want to see things. I can move the activity. I can add things. I can add additional components on the side here. And I can just customize the page however I see fit. You can make the content dynamic by display options. You can say how you want to just show options. If you want to show component visibility, you can select the component visibility here. And then you can also have different page layouts. So these page layouts, these are their standard page layouts. These dictate what you see in the details. So on here, the details section here, this is your page layout that's going to control. This is controlled based off of your record type and profile. If you want to adjust the fields that you see in here, we can go to the account layout here. You can also get to there from the account page. But from here, we can then select the fields and the related list that we want to add to that page layout. And that's pretty much Lightning layouts and page layouts all wrapped up in one. All right, thanks for coming. And if you like this type of content, like and subscribe. I try to produce content weekly, and I will continue producing if people keep watching.